Hi, welcome to this episode of Books and Toast. Before we begin, I must warn you, you must subscribe to this channel of Books and Toast. Otherwise, your WhatsApp account will be frozen.
Hello everyone, my name is Anuya. Welcome to the Books on Toast channel. Today we have a very, very special guest with us. We worked very hard to get him to you guys today because he's a very busy man, and I've had to coordinate with his manager and his agent and make sure the chartered flight lands on time and all of that. No, it's been very tough. But you guys were like, bring him. So I was like, all right, we can do this for the fans. At least this much we can do. So without further ado, let's call to the Books on Toast studio, which is my living room. And there's going to be lots of sounds of Bartan being cleaned in the background. So try to ignore those. Please welcome Mr. Prakash Zagadar.
Anyway, today I am the star of today's show. Mostly because, not because I'm very busy or anything, because my daughter has forced me to be here. You know, all that nonsense that she was talking about is useless.
I didn't force him.
Yeah. So, anyway, but I'm going to talk about the subject which is very dear to my heart and very dear because I'm interested in that. And that is called Marathi literature.
Great. Before that, the reason why he's here today is, of course, this is another Father's Day special. Yay! Thank you, Father.
Yes.
For being here on Father's Day.
No, but I think your channel is quite used to bringing stars, you know, into the light, and I'm one of them.
Okay. So, like he said, today we're going to talk about Marathi literature. Specifically, we're going to talk about five books that you can read if you want to start reading Marathi literature. They are a mix of books that have been translated and that haven't been. But before that, I want to ask him the one question that we ask all of our star guests, which is, Baba, what are you reading right now?
The book that I'm reading to nowadays is Richard Dawkins' God in Delusion, as well as one book, biography of Thomas Alva Edison, which is very interesting. So these are the two books I'm reading, and then last book that I've read yesterday night only, and that is the Silk Route. It's a very brief history of the entire world, and it's very interesting and very beautifully illustrated book. And you can run through the entire history of the world by just reading this book, which will take hardly 1 hour for you to read.
He read it because it was a coffee table book.
It was coffee,
on
yes.
My coffee table. I've not finished it yet. Okay, Baba, that's nice. Why don't you try reading for fun someday? That is also good.
I have forgotten those days because I used to read for fun when I was young, quite young. Later on, I forgot. I kept on reading all the books, non-fiction books basically.
All right, so let's get to the meat of today's discussion, which is we are going to talk about how to start reading Marathi literature. And even though we are talking about Marathi, तर तुम्हाला जर कळलं नाही तर आम्ही खाली सबटायटल्स टाकू, म्हणजे तुम्हाला पण कळेल आम्ही काय बोलतोय. आणि इफ यू आर महाराष्ट्रन देन व्हेरी गुड, यू ट्राय नॉट टू रीड द सबटायटल्स. इट्स लाईक वॉचिंग मनी हाईस्ट इफ यू आर स्पॅनिश. ओके बाबा, टेल एव्हरीबडी की हू आर द ग्रेट्स इन, लाईक व्हॉट आर द नेम्स इन मराठी लिटरेचर दॅट यू मस्ट नो.
फर्स्ट वन इज दॅट two or three authors in Marathi who have got Sahitya Academy Award.
Okay.
So the first one among them was V. Sir Khandekar. V. Sir Khandekar had written a book called Yayati, which is legendary. It's one of the best books ever written in Marathi. V. Sir Khandekar, and then came...
His son, T. Sir Khandekar.
The second Sahitya Academy Award winner was Kusumagraj, that is Viva Shirvadkar, you know. So these are the two greats who got this Sahitya Academy Award, and the third one now was given to Bhalchandra Nemade. And all these three authors are great authors, simply too good, and all of them are very favorite to me. particularly the book written by Visa Khandekar, that book about Yayati, it's a story based on a Mahabharata, small story, I mean a part of a Mahabharata, where Yayati is a king and he wants to remain young forever, right? But in order to do that, he has to steal the life of other young people. And that is how he survives, and his sons sacrifice their life for the youth of this guy. And then there are many complications, but the book is very beautiful. That is my first recommendation. The book written by Khandekar, and it is called Yayati.
Is there a translation?
I think there is a translation available.
Okay.
Because it's a Saitya Academy Award winner, generally these books are translated in English.
Okay.
The second book that I am talking about is written by Ranjit Desai. He has written two books. One is Sriman Yogi, which is based on the life of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. And the second one is Swami. Swami is by far the best novel I have ever written on the historical material. And it is based on the life of Bajirao Peshwa. Madhurao Peshwa and his wife Ramabai. Which was made into a serial also, in Marathi serial. Swami is actually it's a history, Maratha Peshwa's history. Marathi Samrajya, Sambhaji Raja and Rajaram Rajan's Rajya jeva samplo, tevha Peshwani take over kele. And Peshwani take over kele nantar, Peshwan madhe पहिला पेशवा मेल्यानंतर बाजीराव पेशवा आला.
करेक्ट.
बाजीराव पेशव्यानी प्रचंड ही वॉज शॉर्ट लिव्ड. वन ऑफ द मेजर प्रॉब्लेम विथ ऑल दिस पेशवाज दे वेर ऑल हॅड अ व्हेरी स्मॉल लाईफ यु नो. आणि त्यामुळे दुसरा जो बाजीराव पेशवा आला तो लवकर मेला. त्याच्यानंतर काय करावं म्हणून अल्पवयीन माधवराव पेशव्याला तिथे त्याला पेशवा करण्यात आला. अल्पवयीन म्हणजे अतिशय बालपणीच लहान लहानपणीच तो पेशवा झाला. परंतु तरी देखील त्या माणसानं अत्यंत स्ट्रॉंग रीतीनं ते राज्य चालवलं आणि त्याचं राज तो पण लवकर मेला. आणि त्याच्या काळामध्ये ही सगळी घटना घडते. स्वामी त्याच्याबद्दल हे सगळं आहे. त्याच्यामध्ये अनेक कारस्थाने चालली वगैरे.
सो दॅट इज बुक टू.
दॅट इज बुक टू. तिसरं बुक जे ऑल टाइम ग्रेट आहे मराठी मधलं, त्याचं नाव आहे नटसम्राट. हे पुस्तक लिहिले, हे नाटक आहे. नाटक हे ऑथेल्लोवर किंग लियरवर आधारित, शेक्सपियरच्या किंग लियरवर आधारित एक नाटक आहे. आणि मुळात नाटक सुद्धा त्याच्या पुढे फिकं पडेल असं हे ओरिजिनल नाटक सुद्धा फिकं पडेल, शेक्सपियर फिकं पडेल एवढं त्याचं सुंदर प्लॉट आहे. राजाच्या जागी आणि नटसम्राटाची हे केलेली तुलना केली. म्हणजे नटसम्राट म्हणजे असा की जुन्या काळामध्ये महाराष्ट्राचा इतिहास ज्या माणसाला माहिती आहे त्यांना माहिती आहे की महाराष्ट्राची रंगभूमी एकेकाळी संगीत नाटकांनी प्रभावित होती. आणि त्या संगीत नाटकांमध्ये काम करणारे बालगंधर्व वगैरे हे जे लोक होती ते ऍक्च्युली पुरुष मंडळी, पण ती स्त्रीचं काम करायची. आणि त्याच्यामध्ये त्या काळामध्ये जी काही रंगभूमी होती, जवळजवळ 50 ते 100 वर्ष या रंगभूमीने महाराष्ट्रावर राज्य केलं, त्या काळातला एक नटांचा सम्राट म्हणजे त्याच्यामधला एक अतिशय फेमस असा नट, त्याच्या आयुष्यावर आधारित ही कादंबरी हे नाटक आहे. आणि या नाटकामध्ये हा माणूस म्हातारा झालेला आहे. त्याने म्हातारा झाल्यानंतर त्याने आपली सगळी संपत्ती आपल्या मुलांना देऊन टाकलेली आहे. आणि परंतु आपला तो गतवैभवाचा काळ तो कधी विसरत नाही आणि त्याच्या सवयी काही तो बदलत नाही. आणि मॉडर्न त्याचे जे मुलं आहेत त्यांची जी जनरेशन त्यांची सवय यांच्याशी आणि त्याच्या व्हॅल्यू सिस्टीमचा मोठा कॉन्फ्लिक्ट होतो. म्हणजे त्याच्या मुलाच्या नटसम्राट हे नाटक बघण्यासारखं आहे. आणि सगळ्यात महत्वाचं म्हणजे नटसम्राट हे नाटक लिहितानाच त्या नाटककारांनी म्हणजे विवा शिरवाडकरांनी ज्यांना कुसुमाग्रज म्हणतात त्यांनी हे नाटक श्रीराम लागू डोळ्यासमोर ठेवून केलेलं होतं. त्यामुळे श्रीराम लागूनी ऍक्टिंग केलेलं हे नाटक हे महाराष्ट्रामध्ये अजरामर. त्याच्यानंतर अनेक लोकांनी हे नाटक केलं पण श्रीराम लागूची सर त्यांना कोणाला झालेली नाही. पण हे पुस्तक मात्र अप्रतिम आहे.
आता एका लाईनीत इंग्लिश मध्ये समेशन करा, व्हॉट इज नटसम्राट?
नटसम्राट इज ऍक्च्युअली एन अडॅप्टेशन ऑफ किंग शेक्सपियर्स प्ले कॉल्ड किंग लियर. अँड it's a tragedy of an old man. Actually it's a king. He was a king there, but here this fellow is a king of theater, you know, king of theater. He has become old now and he's living in his old times, and he has a lot of conflicts with his new generation. Third book that I would recommend everyone to read is from my most favorite author called Pulo Deshpande.
Yay! Yes.
And Pulo Deshpande has written one book which is the best of all other books that he has written. Ah. That is called Bhattacharya Chitsar.
Bhattacharya Chitsar is
the best.
The literal translation of Bhattacharya Chitsar is
the Chawl of Potato.
Ah. That should tell you everything you need to know.
Yeah. And that was the fourth book, I suppose, right?
I think fourth book.
Fifth book.
Tell them about Bhattacharya Chitsar. Kai Ota Dechat.
Bhattacharya Chitsar is a very...
Kai Ota Dechat.
But it's very difficult to explain what goes on in Bhattacharya Chitsar. But actually it's a chawl. It's some 100 years back, let us say. In Girgaon, the entire story.
Not 100.
I don't know, but around
1960s. That is 100 years ago or what?
No.
Around you can do maths, no?
70 years, let us say. 70 years back, what was the situation in Mumbai? Mm. And in Mumbai, there's a place called Girgaon, and that was the central Mumbai at that time.
Yeah.
That was the main business district of Mumbai.
Huh.
And almost everybody used to stay in Girgaon or nearer to Girgaon only.
Huh.
And that place was filled up all lower middle class Maharashtrians.
Huh.
And they used to stay in a chawl system.
Huh.
The chawl system is something like E-shaped building.
They know what the chawl is.
And, everybody was connected to everybody, and all kinds of characters stay there, and the kind of fun that they have, and the genuine picturization of that era. That's the best part of it.
So I know about Bhattacharya. Of course, as you guys know, I've grown up listening to Pulo Deshpande, so he's also one of my favorites. Matlab, I did all Pulo Deshpande audiobooks before audiobooks were a thing, because he recorded himself doing one-act play versions of solo versions of his solo play staged versions of his entire books.
Book.
I mean, he was a very talented man. So all his all of his books were available as audiobooks, and you should listen to them constantly.
Yeah. Yeah.
And the only one book that was on tape on VHS was Bhattacharya Chitsar. And there is that one chapter, kind of
about
the
chapter.
So, nahi re, apan jo video ho gaya tha to.
Gachi sir,
nahi,
mi upas karto.
That I've seen on
video.
And it was black and white, it is. You can barely see anything, but it is so entertaining. It's better than 80% of the Netflix specials on Netflix, comedy specials. So, that's how good it was. That is my Bhattacharya Chitsar story. Bhattacharya Chitsar is a translation hai ka?
I don't know.
I don't think so. It is very hard to...
See, it's very difficult to translate the comic books of Marathi.
Marathi humor.
The comedy is lost completely.
Not comic
book. Sorry. Comedy books. Whatever.
Correct.
So...
You will not understand. It will not work. So if you are Maharashtrian, then read it
in original. Yeah.
Or if you are like me and reading in Marathi is a problem, then you can always listen to it.
Now it's total injustice to pick up 5 best books, because then so many books are competing for the 5th slot. But I would say, for the serious readers and the people who are really interested in Marathi literature as such, then he must read Kajal Maya, a book written by G.A. Kulkarni.
Hmm.
And this is the one book I think that if it is translated in English and if it would have got a right publicity, Kajal Maya is worth getting a Nobel Prize of Literature in Marathi.
Wow.
Yeah.
What is it?
That is such a... No, it is all about human nature. I mean, there are... The stories are all abstract stories. Fantasies most of the times.
Oh.
Reality is hardly any story, one or two dealing with the reality. But most of them are fantasies. And they are talking about human existence in itself. It is very philosophically rich, and the imagination and all that is just out of this world.
Okay.
So the book is called Kajal Maya. I think that should be number one book if you look at literary point of view. But then I have selected many books which are based on my entertainment value also. So. Thank you for watching this video. If you like it, please share it. And don't forget to subscribe to Books on Toast.